Good afternoon, City of Refuge. Thank you for joining me today on this very cold and very windy Friday for our weekly update. Just want to share with you a few announcements, a few things that are coming up, and then some things that I'd like for you to plan for as we move into the month of February and as we start our journey toward Palm Sunday and Easter and Passover, so that all of our hearts are joined together as we take this journey together. Tomorrow night, January 30th, Saturday night at 5:30, is our next gathering. We will be live in person here at Grace Alliance Chapel at 5:30 and also live on Facebook. This is the fifth week in our new preaching series, that we've started at the beginning of January. And this week, Alex and I will be preaching together a message just called, We Are Called to Go, or We Are Commanded to Go, where we're going to be trying to weave together the Great Commission and the Great Commandment. The fact that Jesus called us to go into all the world, but He also commanded us to love the Lord our God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our strength, as well as to love our neighbor as ourselves. And so again, that's tomorrow night at 5:30. Also really excited, tomorrow night, briefly, we're going to be able to introduce to you the Newman family. Janine Newman is a friend that was a part of our church 20 years ago. And now, here all those years later, her and her husband Neil and her children are preparing to go to Africa to go full-time to the mission field. And so they're going to be with us tomorrow night to introduce themselves and so that we can begin praying for them. And then in the near future, we'll have them back to share their story, to share their calling, and to share what God has been and is doing in their lives. But I couldn't think of a better time to have them introduce themselves then while Alex and I are preaching about the calling to go and make disciples. So again, join us tomorrow night in person at 5:30. If you plan on coming in person, please sign up on our Facebook page or join us via the live stream on Facebook Live. Just a reminder, on Sunday, the service will be replayed at 10 a.m. both on Facebook and on YouTube for those that aren't able to be here or tune in on Saturday night. This week we have a couple of things going on after the Saturday night service. Monday night, February 1st, we have our next prayer meeting. That'll be on Zoom at 7 o'clock. And then on Tuesday night, the 2nd of February, is the next Women Connections Group Women's Meeting. That will also be on Zoom this month. So if you want to be a part of the prayer meeting or the women's group, just send us your email address here and we will make sure that you get the link. On Monday, a link will go out for the prayer meeting, and then on Tuesday, a link will go out for the women's connection meeting. So the next thing that I want to share with you is something that we'll want us to begin preparing our hearts for. We are once again this year going to take part in Seek God for the City. 40 days of guided prayer for all of our communities. And we've done this the last few years, but this year I really would like for us to find ways to be more connected in our prayer times together. So we're going to do some things a little bit differently. One is during this 40 days, so it will begin on February the 15th is our next scheduled prayer meeting. Seek God for the City begins on February the 17th on Ash Wednesday. But from those 40 days, we're going to pray together on Zoom every Monday night. And every Monday night, we'll pray with and we'll pray for each other as we generally do. But we'll use Seek God for the City and the weekly prayer focus as our focus throughout the prayer. But then also, something that I'd really like to do is to have daily Facebook updates for the Seek God for the City prayers. And so they might be text, things that are written, there might be things that are shared, videos that are shared, or even just someone coming on to share their thoughts and to pray together. If you'd like to be a part of that during those 40 days, if you'd like to be a part of recording a video or doing Facebook Live, or maybe even just sharing some thoughts, would you please reach out to me and let me know that you're willing to jump in? I don't want it to be where there's a couple of people that end up feeling overwhelmed and having to do it every day, but I really would love for us to be able to be more connected this year in our prayers. It's great to know that we're praying together, but then to actually hear and see and join together in those prayers, it does something that stirs our hearts and our minds, especially during that time where we're going toward Passover, we're going toward Good Friday, we're going toward Easter, and just allowing our hearts to be molded and shaped by the journey of Jesus, that that same journey would happen in each one of us, that He would transform us during this season, that he would stir His Spirit within us, that we would not just reap from His blessing, but that we would be a blessing for those that have not yet seen and not yet known Him. And so those are things that are coming up in the future. Be praying about them. Reach out to me if you'd like to be involved. The truth is, if you don't reach out to me, there's a good chance I'm going to end up reaching out to you. So if it's already on your heart and you're already willing, please let me know as we start to put this plan together. Next Friday's video announcement should have all of the details for you. The books will be ready, so if you'd like to have a book, let me know. There's also an app that you can download if that's better for you. But if you have any questions, just reach out to me, and next week we will have all of the information needed so that we can be ready to start in the second week or the third week of February. So today, as we finish our time together, I want to go back to the reading plan again. And I have so enjoyed this reading plan for this first month. I love the way that the Holy Spirit has been leading Joanne to put it together for us. And while we're back now in the book of Acts, today's reading was the story of Ananias and Sapphira. My heart is still in 1 John. And while I have kept reading, I have also gone back and stayed in 1 John a bit. And today I just want to share with you real briefly from 1 John chapter 4, verses 4 and 5. The second half of verse 4, John tells us, "The one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world." But then he continues saying, "They are from the world, and therefore speak from the viewpoint of the world. And the world listens to them." You know, there's a great promise that the Holy Spirit who lives in us is greater than the spirit of the Antichrist, which is what John was writing about there, who lives in the world. But I want to go to verse 5, where what John writes very clearly is he says that those who are of the world, those who are of the spirit of the Antichrist, they speak from the viewpoint of the world. I've got to be honest, that one statement has been so convicting for me over this last week since the first time I read it. And it's really made me search my heart, and it's made me consider my words and my thoughts and really ask myself, from whose viewpoint am I speaking? Am I speaking about the things in the world from the viewpoint of the world? Or am I believing that the Spirit who is in me is greater than the spirit of this world? And not just that He's greater as in more powerful. It means that He's greater in bringing peace, and He's greater in bringing truth, and He's greater in bringing joy, and He's greater at convicting of sin, and He's greater of turning upside down the things that have been wrong side up. And so I want to ask you today what I've been asking myself. Are you speaking the things of the Spirit who lives in you? Or are you speaking the viewpoints of the world that surrounds us? We are the light of the world. We are the salt of the earth. Our words are so important. And the words that we allow to enter into our hearts and our ears and our minds are so important. And so I believe that it's really paramount at this place we're in our culture, that you and I, as the body of Christ, that we slow ourselves down and that we make sure we're listening to the voice of the Spirit and we are quieting the voice of this age. And so I'll ask again, whose viewpoint are we listening to? Whose viewpoint are we speaking of? As we share on social media, as we sit and have conversations with each other, are we talking about the events of the day or the spirit of eternity? Are we talking about the things that are passing away or the things that will last forever? Are we being stirred by the truth, or are we being deceived by the enemy? So I want to encourage us today and every day that in this place where we live, where we are overwhelmed often by the amount of information, be encouraged every day by the Word of God. Be strengthened every day by the truth of Scripture. Be stirred and be led every day by the Spirit who lives in us. Paul makes it a command. He says, stay in step with the Spirit. And so day in and day out, I want to encourage us. Ask the Holy Spirit, show me where I'm out of step. Show me where I'm out of sync. Show me where my viewpoint is not yours, but it's the world's viewpoint. And may we be a people who commit ourselves to the Spirit who lives in us, to the Word that shines a light in front of us, and to the Son of God, the character of God, who has saved, redeemed, and transformed us. Greater is he who is in you than he that is in the world. But we must make the effort to walk in his steps and to remove ourselves from the mindsets of the world. I'm looking forward to our time together on Saturday night. I really believe that God is stirring and doing something among us to draw us nearer to each other and to be more like him. Again, would love to have you join us in person or on live stream, and just can't wait to see what God does next. God bless you guys. Have a great weekend, and if you can, stay out of the wind.